A common issue in digital retouching is to match the colors in some area of an image, such as skin tones, with colors from another part of the image or from another image. I picked to show you here a Photoshop top method that, along with an efficient workflow, gives the best results in most of the cases. Let's get started. The workflow presented here involves two parts. In the first part, we'll be set the source and target references for the color tones. In the second part, using Photoshop's info panel and a curves adjustment layer, we'll be matched the target tone color to the source. The most important trick here is working in lab color mode. The lab gamut exceeds those of any other color modes. Converting to lab mode does not involve any loss of color information, so it's a non-destructive operation. More than that, one of the biggest differences between lab and RGB is that lab separates completely grayscale information, the luminance, from color information. This makes it possible to change the color without affecting the contrast between the lighter and darker shades, or conversely, to adjust the luminosity while preserving the chromatic tone. To show how this method works, I chose these two images. The goal is to match the tone of the skin in the target image with the skin tone from the source image. Let's do it. Activate the target image. First, the area to be toned must be selected and the selection saved as a new channel. To take less of your time, I already did it and made an alpha channel named Skin. Duplicate the background layer. Name it Base. Select the area you want to average the target color. Choose a medium light one colored as uniform as possible. Use an appropriate selection tool. Here, I prefer Lasso tool. On Options bar, set Feather to 0 pixels and deselect the anti-alias option. Create a new layer from selection and name it Target Sample. Control or Command click on the layer thumbnail to select the filled area. Apply Average Blur Filter. Activate Eyedropper tool and set sample size to 3x3 average. Click with Eyedropper tool inside the selection to set the foreground color. Deselect. Press Alt or Option Backspace to fill the layer with the foreground color. Press Ctrl or Command T and scale layer content 20% proportionally. Activate the source file. Select the area you want to average the source color. Lasso tool, feather, 0 pixels. Copy selection. Make active the target file. Paste selection. Name the new layer source sample. Control or command click on the layer thumbnail to select the filled area. Apply average blur filter. Hold Alt or Option and click with Eyedropper tool inside the selection to set the background color. Deselect. Press Ctrl or Command Backspace to fill the layer with the background color. Press Ctrl or Command T and scale layer content 12% proportionally. Close the source file. Now let's apply the sample points. Select Eyedropper tool. Shift-click on the visible content of the source sample layer to add the source sample point number 1. Shift-click on the visible content of the target sample layer to add the target sample point number 2. Convert image to lab color mode. Don't flatten. Activate Channels panel. Control or Command click on a skin channel thumbnail to load the selection. Keep the selection active and create a curves adjustment layer placed at the very top of the layer stack. Select Eyedropper tool. In Info panel alongside number 1 here, you can see the lab numerical values of the source reference picked from source sample point 1. Similarly, near number 2 here, you'll find the color values of the target reference in response to the target sample point 2. Now all we have to do is to change the target values with the source ones. The way forward is an appropriate setting for the curves adjustment layer. We're going to activate on image adjustment tool by pressing the button on curves property panel. Then hold shift plus control or command and click with the eyedropper tool on the target sample point 2 in the target sample layout. This point placed on the curve indicates that the corresponding input and output values are now preserved on all channels. This allows changing the output target values to match the input source values. Let's do it! Now the output target values fit the input source ones. Move the source sample layer at the top of the layer stack to apply curves adjustments to the target layers only. As can be seen, though the source and target references are matching and have the same color, the result doesn't look very well. The light tone of the skin gives the image an unrealistic appearance. Now it's time to take advantage of the lab color mode. We can play around with L-channel curve until we get an adequate result. Only luminosity is adjusted. The A and B color values remain unchanged, preserving the chromatic tone. I have to point out here that this method can be used not only for the skin tones, but to match colors on anything. Usually, the task does not finish at this stage. From this point can be started a fine-tuning process. To fully exploit the curves adjustment layer under lab color mode, a good approach is using the blend if settings in blending option panel. About this in a future episode. For now, that's all. If you found useful this video and you learned something new, click the like button and share this video with your friends. Please subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. Ring the bell to get notified about the future episodes. If you have any comments and questions, leave them in the section below. I will be glad to answer promptly.